What causes high blood pressure? Secondary hypertension. 1. Hypertension is a process where blood pressure is too high. The blood pressure is written as two numbers. It can also be defined as a condition in which the blood pressure against the artery walls is too high. Hi, my name is Yami Oryx, and my channel name is Great Yami Channel. I'm here to be teaching you how to prepare natural herbal medicine for your health and wellness. Whenever I see natural medicine that can be of benefit to you, I will like to be sharing it with you. DIY. Do it yourself. This is to save a soul. Even if not many souls in this sinful world we are of today. Follow me step by step, you won't regret you do so. Today I will be teaching you, what causes high blood pressure, secondary, hypertension 1? Please, go down below on the bottom of this video, and smash the red button subscribed, and when you do that you are going to be notified by YouTube anytime my new videos are out. If at the end of this video is going to be helpful, go ahead and give me a like. But if you feel my video didn't give you any information at all, go down and give me dislike and give me comment what I should have done, and how I can do better. Go down if you like or you didn't like and give me a comment below. And also if you have anything to tell me or ask me, go to the comment below and ask me a question, there I will reply to you. With that saying, in this video we are going into the training step by step. Therefore be attentive till the end of the training. Here we go. This teaching is two steps. Step 1. The first, systolic, number represents the pressure in blood vessels when the heart contracts or beats. The second, diastolic, number represents the pressure in the vessels when the heart rests between beats. Usually, hypertension is defined as blood pressure above 140/90 and is considered severe if the pressure is above 180/120. High blood pressure often has no symptoms. Over time, if untreated, it can cause health conditions, such as heart disease and stroke. What you need to know about hypertension causes. The major causes of hypertension include smoking, obesity or being overweight, diabetes, having a sedentary lifestyle, lack of physical activity, high salt or alcohol intake levels, insufficient consumption of calcium, potassium, or magnesium, a deficiency in vitamin D, stress, aging, chronic kidney disease. How to know if you have BP? If your blood pressure is extremely high, there may be certain symptoms to look out for, including headaches, shortness of breath, nosebleeds, flushing, dizziness, chest pain, visual changes, blood in the urine. Causes of sudden hypertension? Common causes of high blood pressure spikes, which typically last only a short period of time, are also known as sudden high blood pressure. These are some possible causes: caffeine, certain medications, such as nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or combinations of medications. There's a good reason why every doctor's appointment starts with a blood pressure check. While 1 in 3 American adults has high blood pressure, about 20% of people are unaware that they have it because it is largely symptomless. In fact, most people find out they have high blood pressure during a routine office visit. Step 2: 10 ways to control high blood pressure without medication. You can lower your blood pressure and reduce your risk of heart disease by making these 10 lifestyle changes. 1. Lose extra pounds and watch your waistline. Blood pressure often increases as weight increases. Being overweight also can cause disrupted breathing while you sleep, sleep apnea, which further raises your blood pressure. Weight loss is one of the most effective lifestyle changes for controlling blood pressure. Losing even a small amount of weight if you're overweight or obese can help reduce your blood pressure. In general, you may reduce your blood pressure by about 1 millimeter of mercury, mHg, with each kilogram, about 2.2 pounds, of weight you lose. Besides shedding pounds, you generally should also keep an eye on your waistline. Carrying too much weight around your waist can put you at greater risk of high blood pressure. In general, men are at risk if their waist measurement is greater than 40 inches, 102 centimeters. Women are at risk if their waist measurement is greater than 35 inches, 89 centimeters. These numbers vary among ethnic groups. Ask your doctor about a healthy waist measurement for you. 2. Exercise regularly. Regular physical activity, such as 150 minutes a week, or about 30 minutes most days of the week, can lower your blood pressure by about 5 to 8 millimeters Hg if you have high blood pressure. It's important to be consistent because if you stop exercising, your blood pressure can rise again. If you have elevated blood pressure, exercise can help you avoid developing hypertension. If you already have hypertension, regular physical activity can bring your blood pressure down to safer levels. Some examples of aerobic exercise you may try to lower blood pressure include walking, jogging, cycling, swimming, or dancing. You can also try high-intensity interval training, which involves alternating short bursts of intense activity with subsequent recovery periods of lighter activity. Strength training also can help reduce blood pressure. Aim to include strength training exercises at least 2 days a week. 3. Eat a healthy diet. Eating a diet that is rich in whole grains, fruits, vegetables, and low-fat dairy products and skimps on saturated fat and cholesterol can lower your blood pressure by up to 11 millimeters Hg if you have high blood pressure. It isn't easy to change your eating habits, but with these tips, you can adopt a healthy diet. Keep a food diary. Writing down what you eat, even for just a week, can shed surprising light on your true eating habits. Monitor what you eat, how much, when, and why. Consider boosting potassium. Potassium can lessen the effects of sodium on blood pressure. The best source of potassium is food, such as fruits and vegetables, rather than supplements. Talk to your doctor about the potassium level that's best for you. Be a smart shopper. Read food labels when you shop and stick to your healthy eating plan when you're dining out, too. 4. Reduce sodium in your diet. Even a small reduction in sodium in your diet can improve your heart health and reduce blood pressure by about 5 to 6 millimeters Hg if you have high blood pressure. The effect of sodium intake on blood pressure varies among groups of people. In general, limit sodium to 2,300 milligrams, mg, a day or less. However, a lower sodium intake, 1,500 milligrams a day or less, is ideal for most adults. To decrease sodium in your diet, consider these tips. Read food labels. If possible, choose low-sodium alternatives to the foods and beverages you normally buy. Eat fewer processed foods. Only a small amount of sodium occurs naturally in foods. Most sodium is added during processing. Don't add salt. Just one level teaspoon of salt has 2,300 milligrams of sodium. Use herbs or spices to add flavor to your food. Ease into it. If you don't feel you can suddenly reduce sodium in your diet, cut back gradually. Your palate will adjust over time. 5. Limit the amount of alcohol you drink. Alcohol can be both good and bad for your health. By drinking alcohol only in moderation, generally one drink a day for women, or two a day for men, you can potentially lower your blood pressure by about 4 millimeters Hg. One drink equals 12 ounces of beer, 5 ounces of wine, or 1.5 ounces of 80-proof liquor. But that protective effect is lost if you drink too much alcohol. Drinking more than moderate amounts of alcohol can actually raise blood pressure by several points. It can also reduce the effectiveness of blood pressure medications. 6. Quit smoking. Each cigarette you smoke increases your blood pressure for many minutes after you finish. Stopping smoking helps your blood pressure return to normal. Quitting smoking can reduce your risk of heart disease and improve your overall health. People who quit smoking may live longer than people who never quit smoking. 7. Cut back on caffeine. The role caffeine plays in blood pressure is still debated. Caffeine can raise blood pressure to 10 millimeters Hg in people who rarely consume it. But people who drink coffee regularly may experience little or no effect on their blood pressure. Although the long-term effects of caffeine on blood pressure aren't clear, it's possible blood pressure may slightly increase. To see if caffeine raises your blood pressure, check your pressure within 30 minutes of drinking a caffeinated beverage. If your blood pressure increases by 5 to 10 millimeters Hg, you may be sensitive to the blood pressure-raising effects of caffeine. Talk to your doctor about the effects of caffeine on your blood pressure. 8. Reduce your stress. Chronic stress may contribute to high blood pressure. More research is needed to determine the effects of chronic stress on blood pressure. Occasional stress also can contribute to high blood pressure if you react to stress by eating unhealthy food, drinking alcohol, or smoking. Take some time to think about what causes you to feel stressed, such as work, family, finances, or illness. Once you know what's causing your stress, consider how you can eliminate or reduce stress. If you can't eliminate all of your stressors, you can at least cope with them more healthily. Try to change your expectations. For example, plan your day and focus on your priorities. Avoid trying to do too much and learn to say no. Understand, you can't change or control some things, but you can focus on how you react to them. Focus on issues you can control and make plans to solve them. If you are having an issue at work, try talking to your manager. If you are having a conflict with your kids or spouse, take steps to resolve it. Avoid stress triggers. Try to avoid triggers when you can. For example, if rush hour traffic on the way to work causes stress, try leaving earlier in the morning, or take public transportation. Avoid people who cause you stress if possible. Make time to relax and to do activities you enjoy. Take time each day to sit quietly and breathe deeply. Make time for enjoyable activities or hobbies in your schedule, such as taking a walk, cooking, or volunteering. Practice gratitude. Expressing gratitude to others can help reduce your stress. 9. Monitor your blood pressure at home and see your doctor regularly. Home monitoring can help you keep tabs on your blood pressure, make certain your lifestyle changes are working, and alert you and your doctor to potential health complications. Blood pressure monitors are available widely and without a prescription. Talk to your doctor about home monitoring before you get started. Regular visits with your doctor are also key to controlling your blood pressure. If your blood pressure is well controlled, check with your doctor about how often you need to check it. Your doctor may suggest checking it daily or less often. If you're making any changes in your medications or other treatments, your doctor may recommend you check your blood pressure starting 2 weeks after treatment changes and a week before your next appointment. 10. Get support. Supportive family and friends can help improve your health. They may encourage you to take care of yourself, drive you to the doctor's office, or embark on an exercise program with you to keep your blood pressure low. If you find you need support beyond your family and friends, consider joining a support group. This may put you in touch with people who can give you an emotional or morale boost and who can offer practical tips to cope with your condition. Herbal remedy to reduce your BP materials. A. 5 bulbs of garlic. B. 5 fingers of ginger. C. 2 bulbs of onions. D. 5 pieces of capsicum fruit essence. Red pepper. E. 1 liter of original honey. F. 1 liter of water. Recipe. Grind or use a blender to blend all together with E and F. Dosage. 2 dessert spoons, 3 times a day. Please, don't forget to go down below at the bottom of this video, and click on the red button subscribed, and when you do that you are going to be notified by YouTube anytime my new videos are out. Thanks for watching Great YOMMY channel.